After firing who knows how many people on NBC's The Apprentice, Donald Trump receives a pink slip of his own. So joining me now, legal commentator AREVA Martin and Kaylee McEnany, editor of Political Prospect. All right, good to have both of you. Good to see both of you. AREVA, you first. Let's listen to more of what Donald Trump had to say today.
I have a great relationship with Mexico. How can I not love people that give me tens of millions of dollars for apartments? You have to love them. My stance on immigration is correct, and some people may not think so, but ultimately my stance is correct.
So he said, how can he not? You can answer his questions for him. AREVA, what do you make of his questions?
I don't know his stance on immigration. What I do know is that he used some very offensive and derogatory language to describe Mexicans that come to this country. And I just don't understand someone using that platform to use such hateful and, you know, hate speech. We watched what happened in Charleston just last week. 9 people killed by an extremist who said he was upset about what he saw in the news related to Trayvon Martin. How do people like Dylann Roof become Dylann Roof? It's because they sit around and listen to people like Donald Trump make hateful statements like those he made about Latinos.
Sure, but I hear what you're saying, but we hear equally hateful statements come from another NBC host, Al Sharpton, who has called Jews white and interlopers, who has said that Jews should pin back their yarmulkes. So if NBC wants to be consistent, I'm with you. Let's not let anyone say anything derogatory, but let's be consistent.
Should he be allowed to? Go ahead, AREVA.
No, I was just going to say, I appear on Reverend Sharpton's show frequently, and I know for a fact Reverend Sharpton has not made any comments about Jews like that in the recent past. He's been very conciliatory. No, absolutely not. He's been very conciliatory, inclusive, reaching out to all people on lots of these civil rights and social justice issues that have been playing out in the news media. So I don't think it's fair to compare what Donald Trump said just 24, 48 hours ago to what Al Sharpton may have said decades ago.
What's the expiration date then on a racist statement? To me, a racist statement's a racist statement. I don't like what Donald Trump said. I don't like what Al Sharpton says. And at what point does it expire and become something that's
McKaylee, in the past? I don't know if that is fair because we can all evolve. Listen, I'm not here to defend either of these men, but many people evolve and they change, and what someone did 10 years ago may not be consistent with their beliefs now.
I understand that, and I want to make clear I don't support what Donald Trump said. I think he said something very inartful, very inappropriate. However, he was hitting at a real issue in this country. You know, we can't have porous borders. Sex offenders crossing the border went up 100% last year in parts of Texas, so this is a problem. He said it in a very poor way. It was not okay, but he was hitting at a real problem.
Well, let's talk about that then specifically. What Donald, his stance on immigration, what is it, and is his stance the stance of most Republicans?
I think that the stance of most Republicans is we've got to plug the border, but I think the mainstream Republican does not want to send the illegal immigrant back to Mexico. I think that they're here to stay. That's not the American way. We're not going to ship people across the border. There has to be some path to citizenship. So in that sense, I don't think Donald Trump is consistent with mainstream Republicans.
Okay.
There's got to be a path.
So Donald Trump
Go
ahead.
Well, I was just going to say, it's surprising to me and really offensive that we haven't heard any of these GOP presidential candidates come out and take a stance against what Donald Trump has said. Although we hear them talking about immigration and wanting to court Latino voters, seems like to me if you want Latinos to vote for you, you're not going to go on national television and call them rapists and drug dealers.
Well,
they may be struggling to figure out how to even deal with Donald Trump joining the race and now being number 2 in the polls.
And Don, I think you hit on an excellent point. You know, Donald Trump has shown himself to be a showman. I don't think he's a serious candidate. So why is it the role of Marco Rubio or Jeb Bush or some of these fundamentally serious candidates to go out and attack the unserious candidate? I think it's a sideshow. It's not within the mainstream of candidates.
But can you call him a not a serious candidate, though, honestly? And I'll let both of you answer this. If he is polling the way he's polling, because, I mean, again, he's number 2 in the polls. He's behind Jeb Bush. That's a pretty good ranking.
No. Not only is he number 2 in the polls, Don, also people listen to Donald Trump. It's not as if this man is not getting major news coverage from all the networks, and it's not as if he doesn't have a bully pulpit from which to spew these racist comments. I think we would all feel differently if this man didn't have such a large platform. So I don't think it's fair, and I think it's disingenuous to say that we can't take him seriously when he's being taken seriously as evidenced by the fact that people are saying they're going to go out and vote for him.
Kaylee, he's had a platform for years. He's been speaking his mind for years on NBC and anyone else will listen to him.
Look, I think when you put yourself out there and you're a candidate who, as you mentioned, for years has been saying he's going to put himself out there and does say these, you know, outrageous things, these things that get people fired up, he's going to have a spike in the polls when he first declares his candidacy. But I'm here to tell you he's not going to be anywhere near the top five. He's not a serious contender within the Republican Party. And I think he made that pretty clear when the most important thing he said in his speech was, I am rich, repeatedly.
So, but here's the thing. If he's, even if he's not a serious contender, as Mr. Nogales says, he thinks that it's a reflection, at least, Kaylee, on Republicans. Do you disagree with that?
I completely disagree with that. I think the mainstream Republican has a great platform. Conservatism, at the end of the day, is about love and believing that the American individual has ingenuity and can get themselves up themselves and harness the American dream. We fundamentally believe that about the American people. We don't believe that you need help from government. And I think that that is the mainstream message. It's a message of love and a message of self-dependence.
Really. AREVA, do you see similarities to how this is being handled to the calls for the Confederate flag to come down because some people waffled and then they wavered and then all of a sudden they had to relent?
I see it being similar, and I think the pressure is on. We see not only NBC cutting ties with Donald Trump, but now the pressure is on Macy's. Donald Trump has a line of clothing in Macy's, and now there's a petition going forward to end that relationship. So, yes, I think Republicans, just like with the Confederate flag, are going to have to, quote, unquote, come to Jesus on this issue. They're going to have to respond. And if they're so loving and if they're so ready to embrace all people, including Latinos, then let some of the candidates step forward and say that. I don't think they can hide behind he's not a serious candidate. And whether he's going to be in the top five or the top 10 months from now, the fact is he's in the top five right now. Yeah. So where are these candidates coming forward making Latinos and other ethnic minorities feel like they're a part of the party and that they do matter?
Kaylee, let's talk about this, because if he continues to poll the way he's polling, he's going to be a part of the debates, right? And so other candidates are going to have to deal with Donald Trump during the debates. And what if he makes a comment like this? What happens to them? How will they respond to it?
I think they'll respond in a very respectful, very good way. And look, AREVA, I think I would urge you to look to Marco Rubio, who our party has the one Hispanic in the race that could be the first Hispanic president ever to take the White House. We are an inclusive party. You can't take one man's isolated statement and try to transpose that on an entire party, on an entire ideology. What you'll see in the GOP debates are very strong candidates and people who will come at remarks like this, hopefully there's not another one, with force and will have a powerful message to counter it.
Kaylee, thank you. AREVA, thank you very much.
AREVA.
I appreciate both of you. I'll talk to you guys soon. We're going to hear from Donald Trump himself about NBC's actions when he joins me Wednesday right here on CNN Tonight. You don't want to miss that. And coming